Hey, so today I want to talk about getting out of a mental health rut and being happy. I am planning a trip with my family and we're going to Virginia Beach for Easter, and I'm so excited, but I'm coming out of a severe mental health rut, and I'm hoping that my family will help me get out of it, or at least entertain me enough that I forget about it while we're out enjoying ourselves. Avery, you should be posting those pictures of your game on Instagram. That's what your father's trying to tell you. Key kind of way. What about you, Boone? You got more footage than that?
Turn around, bro. Show him the name. Show him the name, bro. Game time.
You look nice. I gotta pee. I'm Ooh. Sorry. You look nice. Oh, and
hey, oh Jesus.
Hey y'all. Have to go to the bathroom before we get on the road.
Are you gonna pause it while you're in the bathroom?
No, probably. I'm probably gonna show them everything.
Come on, G. Hi,
Dad. It's G.
Looking like a rap.
He does.
What's going
look, on? Look, he's
about to sit from Tootie. Maybe.
Yes, Snapchat?
Tootie.
I need you up to.
I know you missed them at work.
What? You didn't miss them?
My sister's single.
Why would you do that to
you? It'll show my feet. I mean, they're alright, so it's fine. Hey y'all.
What is this? What kind of social media is this?
YouTube.
Wait to the car.
Here we go. Time to leave.
How you doing?
Oh, I'm sweating. I get that sweat stash. Sweat stash from being hot.
How are we riding up there? Is it household or by gender?
Yo. She said she's driving with
us. Oh, can I get one? This is my niece Kamora. She's riding with us to Virginia Beach. Isn't she pretty? Kamora, am I a good auntie? Oh no! Who's calling me?
What's up? Hello?
Let's get you up. Up. Let's get you up. Up. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, no. Don't do that. No. No. Stop it. Jackson.
Oh.
Avery, move. Two men. Three kids. This man has three girls. This man has three boys.
I'm still going too.
up earlier this morning and we are getting ready to go watch the sun rise on the beach. I'm so excited. I can't wait to go and do this. So I got the lovely opportunity of watching the sunrise this morning on Easter Sunday, and it was such a blessing. It was so beautiful. I really, really, really enjoyed myself. This entire weekend was supposed to be about pulling ourselves out of a rut and doing the things that we love to do as a family. And it has been a lot of fun. We stayed up last night and had wine and jokes and played games, and the kids jumped from one bed to another. And I was in a zone of peace and tranquility and happiness and just ecstatic about what was to come. And what kills me is that I was in this rut, like this really severe rut, and I was down. Like, I was truly upset. Not for any reason in particular, but it was more so because I couldn't get my motivation back to blog, to make videos, not even to like dress myself the way that I normally dress, or to go to work, to make friends. I lost my motivation to do a lot of things. And it's because I was so upset about being depressed, and I was having some medication issues that was messing up my stomach, and I was always sick and all that. So I was down. I was really upset. And I could always count on my sister and Boonie and my mom and dad and the kids to bring me out of it, to bring me out of being depressed and upset. And the goal is to be happy. And if you want to be happy, you got to make happiness. You got to seek it. You got to get off your ass and find it. It's not going to just come to you. And I know a lot of people, especially within the mental health community, they say that they don't want to hear "get over it" and, you know, "come on now, everybody has problems." But the truth is, everybody does have problems. And you don't necessarily have to get over it, but you definitely need to find your happy. Take some time to stop, take in what's going on with you, learn to accept it, or learn to defeat it in some way. And that was an issue that I was having. It was hard for me to accept that I was schizophrenic, that I was depressed, and that I have gotten to the point where I had to be on so many medications and stuff. And it was hard for me to accept the fact that I would have to live this life like this for the rest of my life. But I realized that I'm not my diagnosis. I'm not the problem that I'm going through. I'm somebody who is overcoming and who is surviving through the challenges. And if you want to be happy through something as severe as this, then you're going to have to be proactive and make sure that you find ways to find your happy. So that means I literally have to find events to go to that I'll have to suck it up and go to, and no matter what, don't cancel, and don't renege on my invitation. I have to find people to hang out with that bring the best out of me so that I spend more time with them and learn to be more social again. I have to take my medication on a regular basis. I have to exercise. I have to eat right. And I have to take some time for myself when it's necessary. The goal to be happy is more so about being intentional. Here comes my son. You got to be intentional about being happy. That's most important. Good morning.
Good morning, mommy.
Good morning, babies.
How's your sleep? We need to get.
This trip to the beach was amazing. We had so much fun, the whole family, swimming in the pool, swimming in the beach, walking on Atlantic Avenue strip of Virginia Beach, and playing and having fun at the hotel. I mean, even my father was jumping from bed to bed with the kids, watching my niece grow up. She's getting so big. And talking to my sister and my mother, who are practically my best friends. I mean, I'm happy. And funny thing is, it's like, it didn't come to me. It didn't just land in my lap. That kind of happiness, it was the type of happiness that I actually had to go look for. And that's what I was saying earlier, is that when we go through depression and when we're struggling to self-motivate and self-care and self-love, it's like, how in the world can you find happiness if all you're doing is trying to get yourself out of bed, you know, and trying to get yourself started through your day, trying to get through another day? What is happiness, you know, between people having to work, people having to take care of their families, people having to run businesses and build relationships with other people, whether it's intimate or professional or just casual? Where does finding happiness come into play? And it comes into play as you choosing to take the time out to find those activities and those people that you enjoy and actually put in the effort. Now, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to be completely honest. I did not start off wanting to go to this trip. And when I got there, I wasn't too happy either. But I sucked it up. Not because I didn't enjoy my family or I didn't want to be around them. It was more so I'm used to, when I'm depressed and when I'm upset, I'm used to a certain structure, a certain routine. And when I'm depressed and I'm going through a rut, a mental health rut, I'm not used to doing anything outside of my comfort zone. And my comfort zone is right here where I'm shooting this video. And when I choose to be, because it's a choice. It's not like I'm forced to do it. When I choose to be depressed and I choose to be upset and down on myself and antisocial and not active with people, this is the place that I resort to. And this is the place that gives me comfort and gives me peace, because I'll be afraid. Sometimes I have anxiety about going outside and socializing and dealing with other people, all because of the schizophrenia, the paranoia, the depression, the bipolar, whatever you want to call it. It all stops me from really finding happiness because I happen to be somebody who is dealing with those challenges. So when I say find happiness, I'm like, just, you have to go out there. You have to say to yourself, F this, I'm going to talk to this person and they're going to get to know me whether they like it or not. And if it doesn't work, it works. It doesn't work. If it works, it works. Or you say, I'm going to go after that job that I've been wanting, or I'm going to go after the opportunity I've been seeking out, or start that business that I've been dreaming about. You have to be intentional about your actions, and there's no time to waste. So with that said, I mean, I'm truly excited. I had a wonderful time on my trip. I'm so glad that I could take you with me on that journey, and I'm so glad that you watched this video. Make sure to watch my other videos on this channel and subscribe for more weekly videos. And you can also go to my website. It's www.gaptoothdiva.com. Check out the blog and check me out on social at GaptoothDiva everywhere. GaptoothDiva. Let me ask you, what are the ways that you love to find happiness, and how are you currently finding happiness right now? Leave those suggestions and comments down below and check me out later. I would love to get your feedback. Peace.